I said at the end of the last video that I was going to talk a little bit about how your broken places are a testimony. So I said in the last video how I was going to talk a bit about how the hard places that we go through in life, what I call the places of brokenness, can really be a place of testimony for you, for others in your life, a story that really brings life to other people. The heartache and the broken places, the hurt spaces, those tender spots you don't want anyone to touch, don't even really want to look at it because my goodness, it hurts. Be embarrassing. It can be a lot of things. Really, today, I just want you to know that those places are precious and valuable. And yes, you don't want to expose those things and talk about them in a public way before it's time, but do want to encourage you that not just what you went through, but your process of healing can be an encouragement to others and bring life and even rescue to other people. Cannot tell you how many times I've been in a conversation with a friend where I've been really feeling discouraged maybe about this aspect of my character that I really want to get better at handling, an area where I really want to grow, something that I want to achieve that it just seems like it's taking forever. And my friends will share a story, or I'll be talking to my mom or my dad and they'll share a story, and it changes everything for me. I think about situations in the Bible like Esther getting snatched up to be presented as a candidate for queen, and if she didn't get that position, she was going to be a concubine for the rest of her life. Or Mary becoming a woman who was a virgin and having to deal with all of the scorn and ridicule that came around with that, to birth Jesus, who is the Messiah of the entire world that was and is and is to come. And I think about, women like Harriet Tubman, who risked everything time and time again to rescue people and follow the course in God that made sense to nobody. And even what her story was like to get where she got, with, of course, being a slave in that treatment, and then leaving to rescue people, coming back to rescue her family and her husband, only to find that he'd married someone else, like all that stuff. Women who go through these crazy experiences, and then thinking about your own story, my story. I think about my mom's story, my aunt's stories, my grandmother's stories, and there's so much in those things that, you know, regularly I will be, you could have just met the man of your dreams, or I don't know if you're a guy watching this, the woman of your dreams, and you are figuring out how to put your lives together. You're like, oh, you're the one, this is the one the Lord sent, and now we got to get married and learn how to build a life together. That's still good, but it's hard, you know? You could be in a situation where a new business opportunity came up, or you were ready to change careers and you're embarking on a new course of study in school, and that's so great and exciting, but you've got to figure out your schedule, you know? Maybe you're moving to a new location and you're super excited because you love to move, or maybe you're creating a travel plan because you want to go see the world. Awesome. There's still hardships that come along with those things too. So I'm not only talking about the hard situations in life that make you, the ones that are really difficult and challenging and cause you to deal with yourself and your character and grow and develop and forgive and all that stuff. Yeah, you know, that's primarily what this applies to. But also, I guess what I'm saying is, even with the good changes in life, there are difficult challenges that come along with that growth too. So don't think even that if you're experiencing something wonderful and awesome, but it's challenging at the same time, that it's wrong. No, it's all a part of growth. And so, yeah, thank you for living your life. Thank you for your journey. Thank you for continuing going and being an example to other women out there, because we need your example. We need your story. We need to know how you handle the good and the difficult challenges that come, the challenges that come with the good, the challenges that come with the bad, because that's going to help us all build better lives together. So hopefully that's encouraging and empowering. that's what we're gonna go with. And I've enjoyed chatting with you today. See you in the next video.